Good morning, students. In the third session of this direct and indirect speech, earlier I told that was earlier called narration. Students and my dear junior friends, one fact you must try to know, because last day during 2 to 3 session for standard 9, I came to know that you have a simple vital problem. So today at first, I would like to discuss those problems, because if there are some problems in last session's teaching, it is not my duty to go further. It is my first duty to clear those doubts, and then I should go further. So first of all, one word: transformation. Second word: changing. Say the difference between these two words, because changing is one thing. What is that thing? That is how a thing is changed. But transformation is another thing. It does mean that sense will be same. Here, sense will be same. So, at first one thing you must know, that in reporting verb, I am talking of only reporting verb or reporting clause. RC, reporting clause, RV, reporting verb. At first you must know the difference between these two abbreviations. As earlier, there was the word direction, and after modification, it became direct and indirect speech. In the same way, this reporting verb was the earlier concept, but later on, the grammarian thought that because there are two clauses in our narration. As example, I say he is ill. So this is one clause and this is another clause, because here this verb is related to the reporter. I is the reporter that reports, means that speaks. It does mean because it reports, so it was called reporting clause. Means in this clause, this is reporter to whom we call subject. So because this is, what does this report? This reports its idea, its information, its expression. And what is expression? He is ill. This is the reason that this word subject does the work of reporting. So this is reporting verb, was also called reporting clause. See the reason: reporting verb and reporting clause both are same. Okay? Now, second thing, some students have problem. some students have problem regarding subject plus verb plus object. Some students have problem subject plus verb plus object, comma, inverted comma, subject plus verb plus object. So here this object, whether it is necessary or not, this is a vital question. Because some students think that object will be certainly indirect object, plural speech. Some students think that in indirect speech, object is necessary. No, object is not essential always. Object is not essential always. It will be in two conditions. Number one, if there is object, if there is object given in the direction, like I said to him. So here subject, here verb, here object. But when there is no object, and if it is understood, that someone is telling and am the listener, if it is confirmed, as example, he said, you are helping me. He said, you are helping me. Here it is clear that he said to whom? Who is the listener? Here certainly the listener is you. So in this particular situation, there will be object. Even though object is not here, but it will be object. Like he told me that, because here this is understood. So this will be according to it. Second, so that I was helping me, first person, according to me. Okay, so students, I think it has been clear that if there is object in the reported speech, reporting verb or reporting clause, then object will be in indirect speech. But if there is no object, an example, I say, he said, India will win the match. See here. Here, this is not clear that who is listener. India will win the match. Who is the listener? It is not clear. Here it was clear. You were helping. I was helping. I was the listener. So here we added me from ourselves, because me was understood object. Here it is not clear. Why? Because India will win the match. Everyone may be the listener. So here there will be no object. So here it will be that he said that, no object. India would win the the manager. Okay, so here we have seen the doubts you students asked last day between 2 to 3. You asked the confusion of object. You asked the confusion of reporting clause and reporting verb. So I thought it would be better to clear those doubts here in the class and then to go further next. One confusion also you have. So again, I would like to tell you, because this is common confusion. If you have confusion, then no problem. It is natural confusion. So after clearing this confusion of such formula, I will start the new school part of the lesson further. Sun formula. This was the important confusion you asked last session. What is this? Simply, subject, this is called subject, this is called object, this is called noun change. Okay? So, reporting verb, reported speech. Okay? So, the sentence is the subject of reported speech. The subject of reported speech is the name I, me. The subject of reported speech, if it is in first person, it will be according to the subject of reporting verb. Second person, you. If the subject of reported speech under inverted comma is in second person, it will be according to the object of reporting verb. And if there is third person, there will be no change. Okay? So third person means he, they, me. Okay? Now we are going towards the next part. Now we are going towards the next part, and that is negative sentence. Last day I told you while teaching you the rules of narration. While teaching you the rules of narration, I told you that the first one was assertive sentence. The first one was assertive sentence. Assertive sentence is also called a statement. Assertive sentence is also called a statement. What is the meaning of assertive sentence? Assertive means to assert. To assert means to accept. To accept firmly. Firmly in Hindi, dhritapurvak, ekdam, main isko accept karta hu. So, to accept it firmly, to assert. And we assert it in two parts. First, affirmation. Second, negation. Affirmation, second, negation. So this affirmation becomes affirmative sentence, and this negation becomes negative sentence. Okay? So it is clear. Now I think it is clear that in assertive sentences, there are two parts, affirmative sentence and negative sentences. Normally, less and less questions are asked from negative sentence, but it is my duty to solve one or two problems on negative sentence also. So in last session, while I was clearing the rules of tense, I told you that if the tense of the verb of reporting verb will be in present or future, there will be no change in the tense of the verb of reported speech. As example, say to, says to, or will send. say. Secondly, I told you if the tense of the verb, reporting verb, will be past tense like say, do, it will be changed according to the following. In the following, I gave you affirmative sentence, six affirmative sentences I gave you. What were? Those. Number one, it was simple present into simple past. Number two, it was present continuous into past continuous. Number three, it was present perfect into past perfect. Number four, it was present perfect continuous into past perfect continuous. Number five, it was simple past into past perfect. And number six and last, it was past continuous into past perfect continuous. And I also told you that past perfect and past perfect continuous, there will be no change, it will be the same. Besides this, I told you, shall will change into should, will be changed into would, can be changed into could, may will be changed into might, could have been changed into date, and is and are will change into what we are. So there, now we are going to continue negative sentences. So today, now I am going to add the new things. Till now, I have given you the doubt of last two sessions, what you had confusion. Now we are going to add some negative sentences. So, negative sentence, you all know, when not, doesn't, didn't, if these are when added, then we use negative sentence. So now, negative sentence. In negative sentence, he said to me, he said to me, you are not a swimmer. You are not a swimmer. One more sentence.
So here, me is not understood.
So he was not a good fellow. Okay? So now I hope you would have understood the main part of your assertive sentence. Okay? Now the second one. The second one is inversion truth. First one we saw assertive sentence. Second one inversion truth. Inversion truth means that is true everywhere in every condition. So in inversion truth, the basic rule is this, that whether there is present tense, past tense or future tense. There is present tense, past tense or future tense. There is present tense or past tense or future tense. There will be no change on the tense of the reported speech. Because again I tell you, earlier in a certain sentence, we saw if the reporting clause, if the reporting verb had present or future, there will be no change in the tense of reported speech. But if there is past tense in reporting verb, in reporting clause, there will be change. But here, whatever it is, present tense or past tense or future tense, there will be no change on this, because this statement, this information, this idea, these facts are true to everyone. So see, the teacher told us that the sun rises in the east. Okay? Second one. He said that two and three is high. Okay? Next one I would like to make here.
Okay, thank you. Have a good day.